Hello and good morning, everyone. My name is Katie. I'm an educator here at the Stone Zoo. And today I am with Alfredo, our Eastern Screech Owl. And we are going on a little morning walk of the zoo. So if you have any questions about Alfredo or any of the animals that we're seeing during today's video, please feel free to type them in the chat and we will try our best to answer them through the course of our video. So this morning we thought we would go on a little walk to visit some of the animals that live in our Caribbean coast and Treasures of the Sierra Madre exhibits here at the zoo. And this is actually a really purposeful walk. Going around to see some of the different animals is really enriching for Alfredo. She gets to experience lots of different species that she hasn't seen before or maybe doesn't see very often, lots of new sounds, and it's enriching for our animals on exhibit at the zoo as well because they get to see Alfredo up close. So sometimes they're interested in each other, sometimes they are not. Right now, it looks like Alfredo is interested in our bush dogs, but it looks like the bush dogs are pretty indifferent because they are choosing to nap in a nice sunny spot. So they're pretty much ignoring us, which is okay. We're still going to walk around with Alfredo to let her see some new sights and sounds. So Alfredo is turning 2 next month. She'll be 2 years old and she is completely full grown. Oh, and this is really cool. You might have noticed how her feathers just changed pretty quickly on her body and she almost looks like a completely different bird. So one of our zoo staff just walked by with a wheelbarrow, which is something kind of new for her. And since that was something kind of new, maybe a little, you know, curious for her, maybe a little scary because it's a big wheelbarrow, Alfredo just went into her camouflage mode. So Eastern Screech Owls, if they are trying to blend in and stay safe, they will flip up these 2 ear tufts on top of their head. That helps them better channel noises down into their ears. And they'll also make their body really elongated and thin. That shape plus the colorations on their feathers help them blend in and just look like a branch in a tree. So when she sees something she is not sure of, her first instinct is to go into camo mode and blend in. So we can actually tell a lot about how she might be feeling just based off of her body language. When those ear tufts go up and her body gets nice and thin and long, I know that Alfredo is a little unsure of something. So I just watch her to make sure that she's feeling okay. And when she feels a little bit more at ease, she'll start to puff out her feathers again too and feel a little bit more comfortable. So like I was saying earlier, Alfredo is 2 years old. This is as big as she will get. So she is roughly the size of a potato and she weighs just 1/2 pound. So if you're at home and kind of wondering, you know, what do I have around the house that weighs around 1/2 pound? She weighs roughly the same amount as 2 sticks of butter. So it's a really good comparison. So I can really barely feel her on my hand. And Alfredo came to the zoo because she's actually a rescue. Alfredo was found as an egg out in Western Massachusetts after a tree company just doing some routine tree work cut down a tree that accidentally had her nest in it. So Alfredo and I believe one other egg were brought to the Blue Hills Trailside Museum in Milton, Massachusetts. They were incubated and hand-reared. There were no surrogate, you know, moms out in the wild to put those eggs in another nest. So they had to be hand-reared by people. And when Alfredo hatched, the first thing that she saw was a human. So she imprinted on people, which deems her unreleasable. That means that she wouldn't be able to hunt on her own. She would be too reliant on people for food and for safety. And that is not a safe environment for her. So we were really happy to provide her a home here at the Stone Zoo. And she serves as a really wonderful ambassador for her species here. So we're really happy to have her. And I'm thinking we should go on a little bit of a walk and maybe go see if she's interested in seeing our Chacoan peccaries. So Alfredo is the one animal that I can't really position to face the camera. Owls, you know, it's a pretty common misconception that they can turn their head all the way around, but they can turn their head around 270 degrees. So that's around 3/4 of the way around. So they can rotate it pretty far. So she is just looking all around at her environment. And that's a really helpful adaptation because owls, you might notice, have really big eyeballs. Their eyeballs are so big that there's no room in their eye socket for them to move their eyes independently. So in order for them to look around, they have to turn their whole head. So that's why she's turning that head around and looking. And right now she is looking at our peregrine falcons, maybe forming some sort of bird of prey alliance with them. I'm not sure. We'll have to see. And we'll go over to our peccaries. So our peccaries are out enjoying a nice scatter feed with some grain and some leafy greens today. So we might see them. I believe that's Brant, and then Stoop and Orange. I'm not good with the peccary names. I am good with Alfredo facts though. So one other thing I want to talk about with Alfredo here is kind of how I'm able to take a fully flighted owl out on a walk safely. So you might notice that Alfredo has these kind of black and neon green ropes that are going through my glove. So these are called jesses, and jesses attach to an anklet right on her ankles that's just like a bracelet. Those anklets have Alfredo, they have a hole in them so I can attach that jess right through. And then I attach her jess to a leash and tie it to my glove. Just like if you take your dogs out for a walk, that leash keeps them nice and safe. This leash keeps Alfredo nice and safe. If something did spook her and she did, you know, choose to try to fly away, I can make sure that she stays safely with me. So she is fully flighted. She is capable of flight. And this just makes sure that she's not going to, you know, fly off and not be able to fend for herself. And Rachel, have we had any questions about Alfredo come in?
Yes. So Anne asked if we only have this one owl at the zoo and if we plan on getting more.
Oh, that's a good question. So we have Alfredo is our only eastern screech owl here at the zoo, but we do have another owl here. Her name is Valkyrie, and Valkyrie is a barn owl. As far as our plans to get more, that I am not sure of, not that I know of. Owls are pretty much solitary. They like to be by themselves, except if there's a mother raising chicks. So Alfredo wouldn't really want to live in like a big group of owls, but maybe one day in the future.
And Martha wanted to know, what does she eat? And Karen said, how do you feed her?
Oh, good question. So Alfredo is a carnivore. So here at the zoo, she gets mice and our ground meat that we feed out to a lot of our carnivores. Alfredo is a little bit of a picky eater. So we have found she prefers her mice cut into small pieces. So that just makes it a little bit easier for her to eat. It makes our job a little grosser, but that's okay. It's for the benefit of Alfredo. And she also really likes bugs. So insects are a big part of the eastern screech owl's diet. So in their natural range, they'll be eating, you know, caterpillars, worms, any large invertebrates that they can find, and then, you know, other small vertebrates like, you know, maybe a lizard or a small snake, mice, things like that. So here at the zoo, she really likes crickets and mealworms, and we can feed those to her and her her normal diet in a variety of ways. So we can hand feed her. She does have a beak. It's not super strong, and usually when she, you know, recognizes that it's food and not our fingers, she's really good about only biting onto the food and not us. So we can feed her by hand. That's a really important part of us building trust and a bond with her, because she learns to associate us with food and really tasty things, just like pets might do with treats at home. And we can also hide her food around her enclosure. So that's something we'll do just to mimic her environment. because, you know, in her natural environment, she wouldn't be getting her food handed to her every day. That would get kind of boring. So we do the same thing at the zoo. So I will hide her mouse pieces and her little meatballs all around her enclosure. I might put them inside of an egg carton. I might put them inside of a box or a paper bag so she has to look around and search for her food.
Okay. We have time for one or two more. Lori was wondering, do owls scare or prey after hummingbirds? Do we know?
Oh, that's a good question. I don't know the answer to that. I believe they would probably eat one if given the opportunity, but I also know that hummingbirds are mostly diurnal, which means that they're going to be active during the day, and owls are typically nocturnal, so they're going to be active at night. So I don't know if they would really bump into each other or if an owl would be fast enough. That's a good question.
And the last one from Katie. Could you just say again how we acquired her?
Yes. So Alfredo is a rescue. She was found as an egg after a tree company accidentally cut down the tree that her nest was in. So Alfredo was brought to the Blue Hills Trailside Museum in Milton, Massachusetts, and was hand-reared there. So she was, you know, her egg was placed in an incubator, and she learned to rely on people for food and safety. So that is why she is here at the zoo, because she would not be able to fend for herself out in her natural environment.
Okay, I think that's all the time we have.
All right, well, thank you all so much for joining us today. And be sure to check in during our next Zoo to You. Bye.